Hello everyone, my name is Kevin from Pidgeon Tools. Welcome back to our channel, where we empower you to create stunning 3D art. Today, we are going to delve into the latest feature of the Super Image Denoiser, or SID, the much anticipated SID-Temporal Denoiser. This new addition promises to revolutionize your workflow by reducing flickering in your animations while maintaining high quality results. Let's jump right into it. First off, if you installed any other add-ons in Blender, you already know how to install SID. In case you need a refresher, we've linked our installation guide video right here. Once installed, go to the Render Properties panel and look for Create Super Image Denoiser. This opens up a whole new world of settings. Don't worry if you're a newbie, we are here to discuss SID-Temporal, but if you're curious about other settings, they will be explained along the way. To kick things off with SID-Temporal, simply select SID-Temporal in the denoiser type. Now let's deep dive into these settings, which you'll notice are more detailed than the regular SID. First up on our deep dive is the quality. Now, this option plays a key role in determining the precision of your denoising. The SID-Temporal offers you three quality settings: Super, High and Standard. Super is the most detailed setting, ensuring maximum quality, but be aware, it demands a bit more time. If you're not in a rush, Super is perfect for your final renders. The High setting is the middle ground, balancing quality, speed and memory usage. Standard, on the other hand, is the fastest method, ideal for draft renders when you need quick results. Next on the list are the render passes. These dictate what aspects of your image should be denoised. Think of it as your way of telling the SID-Temporal where to focus its efforts. Here are some tips to guide you. Diffuse pass and glossy pass are on by default, taking care of general surface noise. Enable the emission pass when you have glowing surfaces that are directly seen by the camera. However, indirect lighting from these sources doesn't require this pass. The transmission pass is a must when dealing with materials that let light through, like water or glass. The environment pass is crucial for scenes where your camera directly sees the sky or large portions of the environment. If your scene contains volumetric elements like smoke, fire or fog, don't forget to enable the volumetric pass. Now let's talk about the image save settings. These settings essentially dictate where the SID-Temporal stores your files and in what format. Firstly, the final output file format setting lets you select your preferred format for the final image. SID-Temporal supports PNG, JPEG, EXR and TIFF. Let us know if you need more formats. Next is the image directory. This is where SID-Temporal will save all the frames that it works with: the noisy frames, the denoise frames and the preview frames. Be aware, the noisy frames can consume a considerable amount of disk space. You can select the smaller EXR files option to save space, but note that this is a lossy compression method, meaning some data will be lost. Lastly, Overwrite existing files is an optional setting that allows SID-Temporal to overwrite previously rendered frames. Use this with caution. Remember, the noisy frames require a lot of disk space, so pick a spacious drive. You can also opt for the smaller EXR files if disk space is a concern. Coming up next are the motion blur settings. This is where SID-Temporal introduces its own way of adding motion blur to your scene. This feature comes in handy, especially when dealing with moving objects or camera movements. You have the option to set the number of samples, which determines the precision of your motion blur. Balance is key here. Too few samples may lead to artifacts, while too many can slow you down your render. Shutter speed lets you control the duration of the motion blur effect. Higher values lead to more motion blur. The min and max settings are there to help you define the minimum and maximum limits for the motion blur. It's an effective tool to avoid strange glitches. Lastly, curved interpolation allows for smoother and more natural looking motion blur by calculating it in a Bezier curve rather than a linear manner. For those seeking to push SID-Temporal to its limits, we've got advanced settings. Here's what each setting does. Overscan compensates for issues caused by fast camera movements along the edges of the frame by rendering a few extra pixels around your image. This will slightly increase render times, but it's a lifesaver for scenes with rapid movement. Multi-layer EXR is for those of you who like post-production magic. This setting will provide an EXR file containing all the passes you've selected, giving you more control over the final look in compositing. Preview render is strictly for debugging and shouldn't be used for final renders. The temporal error detection TED filter is a cool feature that automatically corrects any issue arising during the temporal denoising process. This feature has multiple source options to better fit different scenes. Feel free to experiment and give us feedback on what works best for your unique needs. Last but not least, we have the rendering process. Rendering with SID-Temporal is the two-step process. In step 1, SID-Temporal will render out all the noisy frames. This step will freeze blenders to save memory and improve rendering speed. You can view the progress of the render in the system console. Step 2 is where the temporal denoising magic happens. After the first step, you'll have two additional folders in your specified directory, noisy and preview. To apply the temporal denoising, you run step 2. This will create a denoise folder with your denoise frames in your chosen file format. Remember, temporal denoising is an advanced tool that aids in reducing noise and flickering, but it's not a cure-all. The best results always come from a well-optimized scene with adequate samples. But with the help of SID-Temporal, you can achieve high-quality flicker-free animations more efficiently. We're excited to see the amazing work you will produce with this powerful tool. That's all we have for you today. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share it, and subscribe to our channel for more Blender tips and tricks. Until next time, keep blending.